It's Pirates Baseball, next on the show.
2016 Pittsburgh Pirates.
Francisco Liriano, the Dominican left-hander, will get the nod to start here. What's your take on him, EK?
Remember, guys, this is someone that will come at you with four different pitches. He'll change velocity, he'll go up and down, the break on the pitches makes it a real challenge for a hitter.
Coming to the plate now, Ender Inciarte, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Crowd still filing in this afternoon as the game's first pitch is taken for ball one. And that misses for ball four, so it's a five-pitch walk to get us started here this afternoon.
Boy, and he's not too thrilled with that call out there on the mound. And you know what? I don't blame him. I mean, have a look where this pitch is. That catches an awful lot of the plate, and I think I'd be mad if I were him.
In now, Eric Ibar. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Polanco has a read on it. One down. And now a moment to show you the lineup for Atlanta in this one. What do they need to do to get a win on the road here today, Steve?
Well, I think it's going to be really important to understand the pitcher that they're facing and make the adjustments as the game goes along. If this guy's in the zone, then be aggressive. Go up there hacking. But if he's trying to be effectively wild within the strike zone, then you got to be a little more patient and work the count.
Oh, and he breaks, and they've got him picked off. And a good decision to throw as he is toast at second base. Bases are empty here with two men out. Strike two called, and it's even at two. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Ricky Holiday.
Yeah, and Holiday seems to be a little inconsistent when it comes to calling the corners. I don't think he favors hitters or pitchers necessarily, though. You're just not always sure what he's going to call at those spots.
Oh, look at the sliding stop. It's there. He got him.
No way. That was awesome.
So a little difficulty there for Liriano in the first. And now the Pirates will take their turn in a scoreless ball game. Julio Teheran gets the ball for Atlanta in this one. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, remember, he's got five pitches to work with, so that really makes it difficult for the hitter. He can change speeds, ball moving in and out. Not a lot of fun for the hitters.
Into the box now, Gregory Polanco. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Teron gets the sign. Here's the 1-1. And this one misses now to the Pirate right fielder. 2-1. To short, hit hard. Ibar throws to first to take care of him for the first out. Now a moment here at PNC to take a look at the Pirates lineup card in this one. What's going to be the key for him today, Steve?
Just don't be stupid up there. Don't chase balls out of the zone. Move guys along when the situation calls for it. Play the game.
Josh Harrison will get his first opportunity now. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. And with a quick breather here, let's check out the top of the scorecard and see how the Braves align themselves defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric?
Well, Matty, you remember, growing up, right field wasn't a very important position. But here at this level, it's as important as any. And this man plays it as well as anybody. Very reliable, covers ground, always makes a routine play.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Fly ball, heading for the alley. On the move is Bourne. But he's not going to get this one. It's into the gap. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. McCutchen can motor. He's heading for third. And he will make it all the way to third now as that mistake proves a costly one indeed. So a struggle that time for him in center field, and as a result, he'll be tagged with the E8 on the play. Starling Marte gets his first shot now, trying to cash in with a runner at third and two gone.
Yeah, and all he needs to do here is find a hole anywhere.
1-2 now.
Yeah, and I don't think I'd be in any big hurry to challenge this guy again. I'd see if I could make him go out of the zone, maybe chase a bad pitch.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Where do you go from here?
I think he's set up for something off speed. If you can put that changeup below his knees, he won't come within a foot of it.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now. EK, where are you going now on 3-2?
I still got to work a corner. Not just going to throw it right down the middle and grab a strike. Can't be a giveaway pitch.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. This one's down to third. Johnson is up with it. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt him after all as the inning is over. Pirates leave one. We played an inning. No score. Nick Markakis makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second. Down the first baseline. And some problems defensively as they allow him to reach first safely. So definite problems on that last play, and they'll hit the first baseman for the error.
Kelly Johnson
set to hit now for the first time. Lifted the other way out to left center. The catch is made out there by McCutchen, and that's the first out. Now that we have a chance, let's give you a look at how the Pirates align defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, this manager loves to do the defensive shifts, so we're going to see a lot of odd formations as the game goes along. I can't wait to see how it works.
A.J. Pierzynski is in to take his first swings here with the runner still at first and one away.
Well, too bad that last guy couldn't advance the man into scoring position, so now it's probably going to take a gapper to get him home.
Liriano sets with the payoff pitch. And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. But this ball will be caught deep into the corner. A very tough catch there on the run for the second out of the inning.
Yeah, this is all about knowing how to play right field here in your home ballpark. The first step is good, the angle's good, and he runs this one down heading into the corner.
Into the box, Jace Peterson.
Look out, a fastball up near his dome, and that'll wake you up a bit.
And we're going to see a lot more of this because this is a guy who's let it be known that he will work inside. He'll even back you off the plate if he has to.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. All even now, 2-2. Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Too high, ball three. You have to figure that he's really going to need to keep the walks in check if he's going to have success here.
I was thinking the same thing. No free rides. You've got to make these guys earn it.
He spoils another one and will do it again. Count is full. Here's the pitch. Hard hit ball to second. Harrison's got it. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Braves strand one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. John Jaso will lead things off here as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 due up to start the home second. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. To two balls and two strikes now.
Yeah, I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
Now this one sets up a big pitch because you don't want to lose that leadoff guy in a scoreless ballgame.
Hit hard on the ground to second. Backhanded. And the throw to first is in time. One gone.
Batting sixth, third baseman, Jason Rogers.
Jason Rogers steps in. He'll get his first shot at it here. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. That's on the corner to put him behind now. 1-2. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Now, how important is it going to be for this guy to throw that curveball for strikes?
I don't know that he necessarily needs to ever throw it for a strike. I mean, if it's around the plate and he's getting guys to go after it, it's doing its job. But if he starts to get too high or too far outside, then it's just an easy take.
And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now. Hit the other way out toward right field. On the move is Markakis. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Well, I think this is a slider down in the zone and running away. And that's a very difficult pitch to drive with any authority unless you're a guy like Matt Kemp. And this becomes a harmless fly out to right field.
Jordy Mercer gets his first chance here, looking to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Fastball is looked at for strike two.
Now at the plate, here's where you got to put yourself in the pitcher's head and figure out, what would I throw on a 2-2 pitch?
Grounded to the right. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. We'll go now to the top of the third. And we are tied, nothing-nothing.